What's up, people? It's your man Herb Lover coming from the Herb Mobile. Man, it's hot as crap, man. Trying to get some. Okay, man, it's hot as crap. Just trying to get some. Get this AC going before I get out on the road. Well, I was on the road earlier, but, you know, come back out. But anyway, so a couple of analysts, you know, they. Matter of fact, yesterday I put a video out about Lonzo Ball and, you know, him stating that if the Lakers don't sign LiAngelo, you know, he's going to take Lonzo Ball and he's going to go somewhere else. And, I shared with y'all how I felt about it. Now, the thing is that all these analysts are so focused on Lonzo Ball and Kyle Kuzma diss track. Listen, first and foremost, number one, this is the off season. They're practicing. You know what I'm saying? They're in the gym. They're practicing. They're working on their game. So you're telling me that these kids, come on, they're still young adults. You're telling me that it's something wrong with them having fun? I mean, all through history, all through, most of them just stick with basketball. I ain't gonna throw football, not baseball, any other sport. All through basketball, even when I was growing up. Imagine y'all, everybody used to have fun during their downtime. They used to do a lot of fun things. I mean, this is my problem. The problem with the media is they will try to find the smallest things to start depicting and say, okay, you shouldn't be doing this. You should do that. It's like you cannot do wrong in their eyes. No matter what these players do, oh, that's wrong. No, this is going to stop LeBron. Listen, regardless if LeBron James come here or not, that's not going to stop the Lakers from going forward. Simple as that. People fail to realize that. We thinking, these analysts thinking that because when we get LeBron, this is a guaranteed championship. Ain't no guaranteed championship because we get LeBron. It's no guaranteed championship we get LeBron on two other people. Go back, like I said before, go back and look at the Miami Heat. When he had LeBron, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Bosh. They got beat by a Spurs team with a rookie of Leonard. They got beat by a freaking Dallas Mavericks team with only one really star player. So it doesn't matter. I keep telling fans that over and over again. Everybody say, well, you know, we need to get LeBron. We need to do this and that. Listen, wherever LeBron go at, I'm happy for the brother. You know what I mean? I'm happy the brother's at the age of 30-something years old, still playing at a high level. I don't take nothing from that man at all. But at the same time, we cannot sit here and make it seem like, oh, well, the world's going to end because the Lakers might not get LeBron. Yeah, I listen to these analysts. I'm not even going to say their names, man, but it's so ridiculous to hear stupid stuff like that. They're young kids having fun. What you think they're supposed to do? Listen, they're all still in the gym. They still working hard. See, that's my thing. They sit there and only point out the negative, but never talk about the positive of what they're doing. So what they're doing to you, the fan base, is to turn on Lonzo Ball, Kyle Kuzma, and all them. Why? Because they want you to start, like, listen, look, we need to, you know, start pushing these guys out so we can start drawing LeBron in. Because keep in mind, the main reason why most of the players are still here and why I imagine them haven't made a move, they haven't made a move during the regular season, and also they might not make a move this offseason. Might not, I'm not too sure. As in, like, making some trades. The main reason why, because of the fan base, because everybody, I say 90% of most of the fan base support Lonzo Ball. They support Kyle Kuzma. They support Josh Hart. They support Brandon Ingram. We are true Laker fans. You might have some old fans or some new fans who just joined in. They want to get the LeBrons, the PG-13s and all that, but they don't want to see the team develop. And like I said before, in order to build a dynasty, man, it's best to let the team grow together so that way they can stay together. So when time of free agency come, most of them will take pay cuts based on the fact that I've been here. I started my opportunity here. I'm going to stay here, especially if we win the chips. Ain't nobody going to really want to leave unless they want to, like, you know, the ego kick in. They're like, okay, I want to go somewhere else because I want to prove to the world that I can do this on myself, like a semi-Kyrie Irving type of deal. But at the same time, when I hear them sit there and say, well, you know, because Kyle Kuzma and Lonzo Ball have made diss tracks against each other, that's childish. Oh, LeBron not going to come in because he don't want to play with young kids. Wasn't LeBron the one that made all those trades happen? Come on, man. I'm recording. I hate that when people try to type in. Wasn't LeBron the one that made the trades happen? Didn't they freaking make all these trades in order to benefit LeBron with this 12 they got this season? What, Jordan Clarkson, Larry Nance, Rodney Hood, Hill probably the only oldest one out of all of them. He said he wanted to get younger. Think about it. He said he wanted to get younger because they can run the floor. The only difference about these guys, they're nowhere near the Brandon Ingram, the Kyle Kuzma, or Lonzo Ball. That's a big difference. And people fail to realize that, man. I'm telling you like this. With PG-13, yeah, we might make it to the second round. You know what I mean? Probably over the course of time, we'll probably, you know, start working our way to the championship. With LeBron James, we'll probably make it to the finals. You know, because I'm telling you, we could beat Houston. If we get LeBron, we could beat Houston. Houston's not all that. Fans try to make them seem like they all that. All they do is shoot freaking 40-50 threes. They're not all that. Okay, let's get it through our heads and understand that. They're not all that. If they was all that, they had a chance to beat Golden State in game seven. They didn't. Why? Because they didn't keep going to Capella. Capella was dominating. I've been telling people over again, if you get a big man that can dominate inside and put Draymond Green in foul trouble, stuff like that, it's a good opportunity for you to win because now you can play Draymond Green man-to-man. And when you play a man-to-man, you can play more tighter on the perimeter, rush these guys off the perimeter, and play more stronger defense on them. Because Draymond Green is the anchor of that team. I don't care what nobody says. That's what I think. But anyway, it's not going to stop LeBron James if he wanted to come to L.A. You know what I mean? That's why I sit down and listen to some of these analysts, man. It sounds so freaking stupid. I don't know how they get paid, man. It's like, they say the most ridiculous. It's like a bunch of drama queens, man. They worse than women. Oh, yeah, well, LeBron's not going to come there because Lonzo Ball made a diss track against Kyle Cooper. They've been freaking jamming on each other since the offseason. I mean, on Twitter. That's my thing. He said about the diss track. These three have been jamming each other since Twitter. On each other. Him, Josh, all of them jamming each other, making videos. They having fun. They're enjoying the summertime off. They still getting in there and they practicing. They doing what they got to do in order to get themselves where Magic Johnson wanted to get at. But he probably tell them, listen, hang loose a little bit, have a little fun. I don't want y'all guys to be like strung out thinking that, you know, you got to get, that you got to be in here, you know what I mean, where this is all you got to do. It's just basically work out and you'll have no other part of life. They still young. They still enjoying, you know, teenagehood. Well, not teenage, but young manhood, whatever you want to call it. But, you know, all that dumb stuff about, oh, yeah, well, you know, they're going to stop LeBron from coming in. Listen, if LeBron come, he come. That's beautiful. If not, it's all good. We not hurting. Like I said before, we could have made the playoff this season right here. And that came down to Luke Walton, the front office, and the team. Like I said before, if the players would hit their free throws, that was one of the biggest things. Luke Walton, because of his inexperience, the coach, if he would have actually had a better rotation, better time management, like I said, that's another thing. Then the front office, when they were talking about in the trade room, was about trading players, which made us go into that 9-game losing streak because you killed the morale of the player. And also with KCP, when he was going through this personal situation, when he should have sat down instead of coming into play. So, like I said before, we were our own worst enemy. Ain't nobody really beat us. We beat ourselves, man. And people say to me, oh, the Lakers need this, they need that. No, they don't. And I'm just sitting there like, man, do y'all really watch the games? You know what I mean? Because I'm watching the game. I'm observing the game. The biggest problem with the Lakers, I told you before, was on defense of the quick switching. That's the biggest problem. That go down to Luke Walton because it's like it masks their defense because you switching players off and you're getting caught like the likes of Isaiah Thomas playing somebody like DeMarcus Cousins down low. So, you know what I mean? That's on the coaching because you're the one telling the quick switch. So, like I said, we were our own worst enemy. But other than that, man, that's not going to stop LeBron James from coming to L.A. If he want to come, he's going to come. And like I said, we got enough money for two max contracts. And I'm going to tell y'all like this. Everybody talking about PG-13, which y'all fail to realize, LeBron, Chris Paul, Dwayne Wade, and Carmelo Anthony are all friends. I made a video about that a long time ago about the brotherhood. LeBron James said that a couple years ago, he would love to finish his season out where he can get all of them on one team at one point in time. If y'all think about it, with that young squad, with Brandon Ingram, I'm just throwing this out here. You know what I mean? I'm not in the fantasy. We're just throwing it out here for y'all to grab it. But think about it. With Brandon Ingram, Kyle Kuzma, and just say if they do resign Julius Randle, right? And they, you know, because LeBron decided to take a pay cut. Because I made a video about that yesterday, well, a couple days ago. In order for LeBron James to be great, you know, to actually have a team to go against the likes of Golden State Warriors, he got to take a pay cut. You can't have two max players on a team making all that money, and then you got to think about it. Okay, what if y'all get knocked off this year coming up, right? And then all of a sudden, now you got some of these young players, contracts are now are in a situation where they got to renegotiate the contracts. You know what I mean? Where, you know, not renegotiate, but extended contracts or, you know, try to get them to stay on there. So when you sign two max players, I'm jumping around right now. But when you sign two max players, something like that, things can happen. But I'm going back to what I just stated. Chris Paul can take a pay cut. I know he at the end of his rope, but he do win a championship. Chris Paul can take a pay cut. Carmelo Anthony could take a pay cut. Dwayne Wade has been taking pay cuts since he was in Miami. So if all four of them decide to take a pay cut and keep the same nucleus of young players, every sign Julius Randle, because it can happen. If they all take major pay cut just for this 1 year, because once they're on, then they can start renegotiating contracts on that, plus the Aldane contract fall off after next year. So think about it. If all of them get on, right, and they all take pay cuts just to build this squad, and I'm not saying that we want Carmelo Anthony, because Carmelo Anthony, he got to opt out. But I'm just saying, if they all get on, then you can have a team that actually can really fight against Golden State because you got some young players mixed in with some veteran players, and they be the team to beat. Even if it's just Chris Paul and LeBron James. Because Chris Paul, I don't care what nobody say, man. Only thing I heard Chris Paul is that he just stay injured. But other than that, Chris Paul is a hell of a freaking defender. And I know, I think Mike from Lake Show tried to belittle Chris Paul a long time ago, said he ain't a good defender. don't know what Mike be looking at. Mike, you my brother. I love you and all, but Chris Paul is a hell of a defender. Chris Paul was there. Like I said before, we don't know. Go to State, the referee right in front of the way to, you know, to have him win or whatever. I don't freaking know. I'm not going to get into that. Because at the end of the day, it don't matter if Go to State or Houston was there. The ratings still were going to be pretty good. But if Chris Paul was there, it would have been a different game. Now, would Houston would have won? We don't know. That's a what if. Like I said before in my last video. But Chris Paul played good defense on Steph Curry. You say what you want. But my thing at the end of the day is that LeBron James can make moves where he can actually take a pay cut and bring a couple bodies with him. He ain't got to bring all the three I just stated. He can actually talk to Paul George and say, look, man, let's take a pay cut, go there. Because remember, Paul George can sign with the Lakers for basically nothing, right? For like a couple, for like, I think I said before, like $20 million or whatever, right? He can sign, because remember, the Lakers have, I think, $66 million. So him, LeBron, can sign for $20 million piece. I'm just stating this. And they can still sign Julius Randle, right? Now, here's the thing. Once they get on the team, now Paul George is able, after the year, he's able to get the veteran pay, which is going to be much higher than if he would have just went on and signed on with the Lakers, which that's another thing that he got to think about. I'm telling you, LeBron James is a mastermind. He's going to put something together in order to get back into that final. But personally, I don't really think he's coming to the West. That's just me. I think he might sign with New York or probably Boston. I mean, Boston might make some moves, make some changes. I mean, him and Kyrie Irving, that's crazy, right? But that's why, if you think about it too, and I'm gonna let y'all go. Notice he's been like kind of like showing man love to Kyrie Irving, and like towards the end of the season and during the finals, talking about he didn't want Kyrie Irving to leave and all this other stuff, man. Never know, man. Danny Ainge might make a move. Danny Ainge is a mastermind too. He might make a move and probably get LeBron James and shock the world. Seriously, you know, he let freaking Kevin Garnett and all them boys go. You know what I mean? He let them go with the heartbeat. You know what I mean? Like, oh, all of them, y'all gone. I'm gonna make some changes. And Danny Ainge is not afraid to put the pink slip out. But anyway, like I said before, regardless of LeBron coming to LA or not, that's not going to stop us, man. Like I said, we just growing as a team. And the more we get to know each other, the better we're going to become. That's my opinion. So LeBron James ain't going to stop us from, you know, getting to where we need to get. If we get him, that's good. But if we don't, it's all good, too. I mean, ain't nobody going to be zapping out because LeBron James don't want to come to LA. Come on, man. He done did that before. You know, to then make you wait 2 or 3 weeks and then decide where you're going to go at. And then by the time that happened, somebody, one of our players or somebody on another team like the previous years, you know, go sign with somebody else because we're waiting around LeBron. Nah, man, screw that. Give him 2 weeks. Let him figure out what he's going to do. If he don't stay within 2 weeks, we go ahead and start making a move. Don't sit around and wait on LeBron, man. LeBron, yeah, he's the face of the NBA, but we should not kid ourselves to LeBron. We did that with LaMarcus Aldridge, and look what happened. We lost out on a lot of players because we sit there waiting on LaMarcus, getting him to come to a second interview, right? Because Kobe already let you know, basically, listen, when he told Kobe come there, Kobe like, look, he told him straight up. You know what I mean? If you don't want to be here, you know, we don't want you here. That's how he basically said it. If you listen to some of his comments. So LaMarcus Aldridge probably felt like he wasn't needed. So when they bagged him to come to the second, interview. You know, and the guy made a wake. So we lost out with a lot of players trying to win on LaMarcus Aldridge, who wound up signing with the Spurs. So, nah, man, 2 weeks. Paul George want to come in cool. If not, he wants to say, okay, see, let him. Yeah, I mean, we got young players, man, that going to be pretty good, man. And right now, ain't nobody beating Golden State back-to-back in championship. You might get one championship out of a championship run and beat Golden State that 1 year. But the next year, they're going to come back and win a couple more. As long as KD on that team, ain't nobody beating them boys, man. So why are we trying to build up a freaking a tank to fight, get a nuclear freaking missile? I just don't get it. Anyway, y'all, I'm out. I'm hyped. Listen, y'all take care. Have a blessed one. It's your man, Urban Love, reporting from the Airmobile. Y'all be safe out there. You know what time it is. The world's getting crazy by the minute. But don't you get caught up in it. Love y'all. Peace and out.